Good evening and welcome, and thank you very much for coming along to this fifth Handheld Learning Conference and the second Handheld Learning Awards. I'm going to hand over to our host and MC for this evening, Jason Bradbury of The Gadget Show, and recently he's toured over 20 schools in the UK with his fabulous Dot Robot Roadshow. Jason, please, over to you. Thank you.
Oh, great. Oh, it's brilliant. Thanks very much. I'm so excited, I really am excited. I've got to tell you something, all right? I haven't prepared anything to say to you, I just thought I'd hit you with my enthusiasm, all right? Which is, if there was one sort of little thing on my CV, it would be, is very enthusiastic. That's kind of what I do for a living. And do you know what? When I do events like this, even when the paparazzi are there, you're not child support, are you? No, that's all right then. It's all made easier when the actual stuff you're talking about is good. Trust me, last time I was in this room, it was kitchens and bathrooms. 2009, all right? Today, in all sincerity, obviously I'm supposed to be positive. That's why I'm up here. Do you know what? Honestly, from the heart, I have been wowed. Haven't I, Graham? Haven't I really been wowed by today? I've been here for quite a while. I've been here since lunchtime. In a room, a very sweaty room, with lots of young people, lots of very young kids, actually, eight years and upwards. And they've been showing me their, and a bunch of other judges, their technology. And I'm blown away by it. I really am. And trust me, when I say that, it means something. You might not know the gadget show. You might not know me, okay? Let me tell you that my day job takes me to South Korea, Japan, America, all over Europe. Every month, I'm all over the joint looking at technology, cutting-edge new ideas, science. I go to laboratories. I get to see the most advanced technology in the world close up. And to say that I was in that room this morning, or this afternoon rather, and I was amazed really does mean something. What those kids were doing was incredible. Their iPod touches, with their geocaching, with their mobile phones, it was really, really, truly inspiring. In fact, there was one phrase that really hit me today, and to you, it might be old school, okay? You might have been using this all the time, but for me, this phrase is a mantra. It's going to be my catchphrase, okay? I've been tweeting about it already. The phrase is play attention. Now, this might be a buzzword. It might not be. It might be something that none of you have heard. It might be something you use in your working day. But for me, it really does encompass everything that's great about what you're doing over these 3 days. It is 3 days, isn't it? And also what, for me, essentially was the problem with education. Now, here's the thing. I was in the education system for a long time. I failed my 11 plus. And I went to the thicky school. And to make it even worse, my brothers, that was what my brothers called it, my brothers went to the grammar school. And that was tough for a youngster when there was three of us all as a gang, and I went to the secondary school. And ever since then, I kind of fought my way up to try and get myself an education. The funny thing was, it was technology that enabled me to do it. This was the 80s. I had hair. Okay, I had the whole flock of seagulls thing going on. Beautiful. In fact, I actually think the reason I'm bald is because of the product I put on my hair during that fateful decade. But it was technology. It was the burgeoning home computer. It was the time when, you know, computing was happening for the first time for real, when computer games were given birth to. It was the turn of the 70s and through the 80s decade. And so for me, all of this means an awful lot. And I hope that you think that you realize that I'm being absolutely sincere when I tell you that today's been an important experience for me. Anyway. Enough about me. Let's get on with the awards. Welcome to the Handheld Learning Awards. These days, with national curriculums, league tables, and relentless testing, it's not easy for teachers and practitioners to innovate within their practice. Yet this is something we must depend on for the benefit of future generations. Without innovation in learning and teaching practice, the young people of today will face fierce challenges in the future. In a fiercely competitive world, and I've got to tell you from personal experience, when I take my book around to schools, which I was doing just last week, one of the slides that I show pupils, sometimes there's 500 of them in a big school hall from various schools, they've all pulled together in rural regions, and I go in there and I talk to them about technology and robots in particular. And one of the slides I show them is of three brothers that I met in South Korea. The brothers were from Japan, and the youngest of them was six. The other brother was eight, if I recall, and the oldest was 10. And I said to the six-year-old, in fact, he's from Japan, but they're in South Korea, and he says to me in English, I say, what are you doing? And he says in perfect English, this six-year-old boy, we're making a firefighting robot for this competition. The competition that I'd gone to film for the gadget show was the Robots Olympics in South Korea. The six-year-old was building a robot to put fires out. I said, what's your brother doing right now? He said, we couldn't make the stuff they gave us work, so we've got a PS2 controller, a PlayStation 2 controller, and we're modifying it for Bluetooth. And he's 6 years old. And so when I say, or rather through the conduit that is Graham, I say, you know, the importance of technology in all of learning, it really is super important if we're to maintain our place on the world stage. So it comes as a great pleasure to see an award show that isn't purely about things or products, but about the hero innovators amongst the education professions. Tonight is a celebration of these people, and indeed all of you, the people that are thinking outside the box, prepared to take risks, prepared to innovate for the sake of better learning and better teaching. Before we start the presentation of the awards, I'd like to invite Graham Brown Martin, who, as some of you know already, is the founder of the Handheld Learning Conference and guilty for this evening's party. I'd like to invite him to come up onto the stage and just say a few words. Graham.
Thanks, Jason. That was cool. This will be quick. 200 nominations, 8 independent cross-sector judges, 36 finalists, more than 4,000 public votes, 0 sponsors. In a democracy, I guess this means that we must be doing something right. In breaking the tyranny of agenda-based backslapping in favor of genuinely independent practitioner and innovation-focused awards. As a consequence, the achievements of all whom we come to celebrate tonight is not only genuine, but hugely significant. It also presents some tactical issues, which is why I know that you won't mind that I've enlisted members of my family and close friends to present some of the awards. After all, they haven't seen much of me lately. It gives me great pleasure to be hosting these awards tonight because I know from my personal interactions with the majority of the people here the huge amount of talent, innovation, and passion for learning, improving people's lives, and despite obstacles, helping people reach their potential. It's quite obvious that it is rare that those in the teaching or training profession to get rewarded for innovation or even achieving results that make a difference to so many people. Performance metrics are all about league tables, cost savings, and getting meat through the factory. My experience of the people here tonight is almost a rebellion where practitioners and innovators still hold on to the belief that positive change and transformation is possible. We know these awards aren't perfect, but we've tried to innovate with them ourselves. In a globally connected world, we've made them as international as we can in the hopes of fostering the exchange of best practice and experiences. We didn't want to submit to any particular agency or industry partner that would skew the criteria for deciding who would win. We deliberately made nomination free, shortlisted for finalists by a panel of cross-sector judges who often disagreed, and then in all cases bar one left the final decision to the general public. Well, clearly, our decisions didn't suit the agencies or other organizations that, despite the obvious success and prestige of these awards, felt uncomfortable with the idea of independent Maverick Awards program designed to spotlight innovators and innovations that didn't quite fit their manifesto. At least, not yet. So I'm delighted to be here holding a party with so many innovators present. Enjoy this evening and cheer for everybody who takes a stage as well as yourselves. This is your evening. Thank you very much. Jason.
Come on, rebels, let's cheer. The revolution starts here. Fantastic. Well done, Grant. So now we have the first of 5 awards categories, primary learning and teaching. In each category, there are 2 awards, one for a practitioner, the other for an innovation which might be a project, an initiative, an organization, or a unique product or service. To announce the winners in the primary category, I'd like to welcome Forrest and Andre to the stage. Right, sister. You boss your brother around. Just get it right.
He's
get in the right order.
Brother.
I'm sorry. Whoever he is, just boss him around. Got that one wrong, didn't I? God. Okay, after you.
Hi, Jason.
Hello, Jason.
Hi, guys.
My name is Forrest, and I go to a primary school in Lewisham.
And my name is Andre, and I go to a secondary school in Lewisham.
I use an iPhone, Nintendo Wii, PlayStation 3, and an iMac at home, which I use for playing games like Star Wars and Spore, meeting my friends in Moshi Monsters, Club Penguin, and Spine Worlds. I sometimes fix my mum's computer. I wish I could use my iPhone at school, but it's not allowed.
Boo.
I spend more time playing video games or on the internet than watching TV. I'm also not allowed to use my phone at school.
Boo.
We are excited
about the future
and hope our schools will accept the technology we use.
Oh, Jason, the winner of the Practitioner Award for Primary Education.
1 second, no, oh. Good work. I would have jumped in there were you not bossing it so well. And I thought, well, it would be wrong to jump in. Let's read the finalists first, and then we'll go to that bit. All right, the finalists are Carl Faulkner, head teacher for Normanby Primary School, Amanda Barrett, teacher from Wilbury Junior School, and Jonathan Nolder, teacher, Tullawong State School, Australia. Okay, Forrest and Andre, please open the envelope. Tell us who the winner is for this year's Primary Practitioner Award. Go for it, Forrest. Pull it. It's glued down. A lot of spit's gone into that envelope. Okay, who is it? Nice and loud.
Carl Faulkner.
Carl Faulkner! Carl Faulkner. Where's Carl?
Asked me any hard questions like the kids earlier.
I promise.
It's very nice to be here. It's very nice to be in a room full of so many schools, so many people working in their own way to try and make things a better place, a better way for our kids to grow up. I'm really pleased to be here. My kids came earlier. They presented to a big group and they did it better than I can do this now. Thank you to the people who've helped my school to achieve this. And Andrew Stogdale's somewhere in the room, he's worked really closely. Nicola Padgett, fantastic teacher. I've got some brilliant staff, I've got some brilliant kids and brilliant mums and dads, carers of different kids, who've let us as a school try and do something new, something our own way. So thank you to them and thank you to you for this.
Well done, my man. Congratulations. Come on. Stay here. Okay, thank you. Well done, Carl. And thanks to Andre and Forrest.
Jason, the winner of the Innovation Award for Primary Education is...
Have we announced the finalists? Have we? Huh? I'm very confused. I'll leave it to these guys. They seem to know what they're doing. It's Normanby Primary School.
Normanby Primary School.
Normanby, come on up.
It's the name of the game, and I want to play the game with you. Life can be terribly tame if you don't play the game with two.
Can I just say ditto? And Andrew Stogdale, can you come down wherever you're hiding? Because you've done this as well. Needs to be here. He's not very tall, so it'll take him a while. It's all right, it's a pleasure. It's all about having the passion to try and do things in your own way and trying to make things different. Andrew's got that, Nicola's got that. I'm just really lucky that they're on my staff, or my governing body, as it is with them. So thank you two. You've done really well.
Thank you, Carl. And Norman, being a quick photograph. Thanks. Well done, guys. Well done, Carl and Normanby. Are you finished? Go sit down. Andre and Forrest, ladies and gentlemen. Fantastic. Okay. Now we're on to the secondary education category awards, which will be announced by UK education consultant and rumoured to be Graham's twin brother, Adrian Hall. Come on up, Adrian. Just take your time, Adrian. That's not a lull that you feel. It's just us showing our appreciation. That become.
Well, thank you. I mean, someone earlier said to me that Graham and I are never seen in the room at the same time, which is probably just as well. But we do exist separately. I believe tonight I'm taking the part of Graham's dog to award these awards. Is that correct, Graham? Yeah. I was away on holiday and I got an email saying his dog couldn't do it, so could I. So I am here. So the Secondary Practitioner Award. Do we have a list?
Oh, we've got a list. Yeah, the finalists are Mark Richardson, Thomas Hardy School in Dorset. I hope I'm saying that right. Sandra Taylor, Ashton Sixth Form College. I certainly said that one right. And Alan Beecham. Adrian, please let us know the winner of the Secondary Education Practitioner Award category,
the
please.
The winner is Sandra Taylor.
Hooray!
Thanks very much for, first of all, for O2 for nominating me and for Handheld Learning Awards for putting me in this position, and all my friends out there, oh, Lil, no! just thank you.
Couldn't have put it better myself. Well done! Thank you. Thank you both. We need another photograph. I just feel bad for these guys having to... I want to do a different expression each time, just to keep it a little bit fresh, OK? Only 19 more expressions to go. It's time to take a look at the innovation in the secondary education sector with the Secondary Education Innovation Award 2009. From Ireland, we've got Learnosity. From Holland, we've got Games Atelier. And from Australia, we have StudyWiz Mobile eLocker. Adrian, it's over to you. Let us know who the public have voted for in this international lineup of finalists.
And the winner is Learnosity.
Brilliant.
Thanks very much. Just like to thank everybody who voted for me. I'd like to thank Rod from the Open University and our clients in Australia and in Ireland. And that's about it. Thanks very much. Cheers.
Go. Pretty cool. Brilliant. That started as a surprise, but it morphed into a smile. That wasn't meant to happen. Well done, guys. Okay. Now we've got the category for Tertiary, Further and Higher Education Practitioner and Innovation Awards. To tear open the envelopes and let us know who the winners are, I'd like to ask, in clearly what has become a family occasion, Wren Brown-Martin to come and announce the winners. Come on up, Wren.
Hello, hi, good evening. It's an honour that Graham has coerced me into announcing the winners in this category this evening. He knows that I'm new to public speaking, so you'll have to excuse my delivery, but trust me, you will pay for this later. I'm currently a master's student at Goldsmiths, so I have an interest in the area of higher education. I must, however, confess that I have absolutely no interest in technology, But being married to Graham has meant that I have at least all the gadgets at home, even if it means asking the children to help me use them. I have the envelopes for Practitioner and Innovation Award winners, so please let me know when you're ready for me to open them.
I am ready in a second. Thank you, Red. The finalists are Philip Marston, a learning technologist from the University of Aberdeen, James Clay from Gloucestershire College, and Keith Burnett from Chichester College. Okay. So, Ren,
right.
Why don't you let us know who the winner is?
Okay, so the winner for Further Education and Higher Education Practitioner Award is...
Who glued these? What kind of tongue? What kind of tongue has the person got that glued these down? Okay.
Keith Burnett.
Keith Burnett!
Challenge, asking the questions to Jeremy Paxman.
Well, Jason, it's is it the G Awards and Gadget?
No. But wait, are you talking about the G Stars?
The G Stars.
Five Gs you got.
That's five Gs.
Five Gs there.
Well, yeah. I've got one G. Well, first of all, I'd say thank you to everybody nominating me and. Voted for me. I find this incredible. I'm actually standing up here right now. But my G is glad. And boy, am I glad I'm here tonight. So thank you very much.
That's a pleasure. I love you so much. Let's get a picture. Okay, fantastic. Okay. Moving on swiftly, let's find out who's the winner for innovation for tertiary FE and HE education. The finalists are Molnet, ALPS program or ALPS program, and ACU Connected Initiative from Abilene Christian University in Texas. Ren, the winner, please.
And the winner of the Innovation Award for Further Education and Higher Education is...
I'm not sure, let's go for
ALPS. ALPS program.
ALPS, ALPS, whatever you call yourselves, you're a winner.
To thank everyone from five HEIs, we've worked together, and 18 health and social care disciplines who put their tribalism aside to achieve this tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
So a fertile area for innovation is, of course, technology that enables access and engagement to a larger number of people. This award category is in the recognition of innovators and innovations without which there would be people unable to reach their true potential. To announce the winners, let's have US education consultant and handheld learning guru Tony Vincent to come and say a few words and open the golden envelopes. Up you come, Tony.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. Well, actually, as a kindergartner, I was a special needs student. Instead of the school trying to meet my needs, they actually just kept me in kindergarten another year, and I almost had to be in kindergarten for a third time. It was really difficult. I know it's really difficult to motivate some students, but the school's got to try. And it's great because we have technology that can help us reach students with special needs and all students in different and meaningful and innovative ways. So It's really great that our nominees are doing important work, meeting the needs of students in new and better ways.
Thanks, Tony. Fantastic. The three finalists are Steve Kilpatrick, the deputy head teacher from Charlestown Community Primary School in Salford, Casey Kelly Markwick from Oakwood Court College, and Arthur Sargent, a stream leader from Leeds Metropolitan University. Tony,
the moment of truth. I should have opened this envelope like 10 minutes ago.
Absolutely.
All right, the winner is Casey Kelly Markwick.
Fantastic.
Is ghasted. I'd like to thank Keith Burley from Phoenix Learning and Care for nominating me, and for Paul Collins, the principal, for making me sound so good, and of course to all my students who all use their mobile phones to vote for me, so thanks very much.
Okay, the next category celebrates the best in special needs and inclusion. So the three finalists in the Special Needs and Inclusion Award are Games for Life, Captura Talk, and KNFB Reader Mobile. Tony, the winner, if you please.
The winner is Captura Talk.
You're a woman, right?
Well, thank you. This is a real surprise. I wasn't expecting this. Thank you to everyone that voted. This is a piece of software designed by people with dyslexia for people with dyslexia, and we hope that people take it and use it, and it helps people's lives. Thank you very much.
Fantastic. Well done.
Quick photograph.
Fantastic. Well done, guys. And, of course, thanks to Tony as well. Okay, now for a new category award and an indicator of how the commercial world is rising to the challenge of mobile learning. Pretty much everyone in business or otherwise has a mobile phone. Surely, this is a perfect opportunity to provide access to learning. Let's discover who are the innovators working in the world of business and training. For this award, I'd like to call up a former chairman and president of Sony Europe, and now chairman of Codemasters. They make some of my favourite games. Chris Deering to announce the winners of this year's Business and Training Innovation Award 2009.
Hi, Chris.
Well, we were here last year, and the crowd has grown, and the enthusiasm has grown. I've been involved with handheld learning, Learning Without Frontiers, for 5 years now. This is the fifth annual handheld learning conference, and it's exciting to see how much broader the base of companies and institutions are that are getting involved with the embracing new technology. Jason was mentioning a six-year-old developing a firefighting robot and adapting a PlayStation 2 controller to Bluetooth. If you take this through to its logical conclusion, another 10 years, we'll be going to school and the kids will be teaching us. But they do know a lot more than sometimes we believe they do. And it's up to us. As parents and teachers to embrace their technology and embrace every new development, and that's what this is all about. The award that I'm presenting tonight is for innovation in learning technology, performance, and training. Performance evaluation and training. As Jason said, mobile phone, especially smartphones now, are becoming ubiquitous and becoming much more available to innovative companies in their training and appraisal techniques. Also, potentially cost saving in this difficult time, avoiding those expensive hotel conferences and PowerPoint presentations to put people to sleep, and giving the opportunity for people to individually receive feedback and to give their own feedback to companies. So without further ado, this is, I think, a very important new development in the handheld learning area, and we have the award that I'm going to give, but first I'll let Jason explain the finalists.
Yeah, absolutely. You just get working on that envelope. It may take some time. thanks. The four finalists in this exciting new category are Cantu English by Lamarck Vision from Israel, Intuition Mobile Learning from Ireland, Goal Training and Development from Australia, and Drona by Deltex Infotech from India. So Chris, who's our winner?
Well, this is a very multicultural international event, and I'm happy to say that the winner is Drona by Deltex of Infotech.
Great moment for us at Drona, and I'm really excited, and thanks a lot for everyone who voted for us, and thanks a lot for Handheld Learnings for giving us a chance for this recognition. And I feel the vision which we hold for improving the learning and training at Deltex Infotex is just starting with this recognition. Thanks a lot.
Okay, now we come to the last award of the evening, and perhaps this one you've all been waiting for, given the caliber of the shortlist determined by the judges. The award for special achievement. I'd like to invite Graham Brown-Martin back onto the stage, founder of Handheld Learning and this event. Please, it's quite a simple one, this. There aren't any finalists. There is just one winner.
This is the real tough one in our Grammys of educational learning awards. And it's a difficult one in when the judges, who I mentioned earlier, are cross-sector deliberately. This is the one that takes the longest to decide. We don't do it via public vote because we don't want this to be a popularity contest. We want to recognize the person that has achieved the most since last year. So this is not a lifetime achievement award. It's somebody who has transcended their current role. So it's someone within a particular situation, particular position, that has done more to impact and affect their peers and has shared that information amongst their peers. So this is a very tough decision to make. And like I say, this is the one that takes most of the time for the judges to decide. And trust me, this went on and on and on before we came up with this one, before we came to a unanimous decision. So can you imagine? And you look at that list of people, and you can understand why. All of these people are fantastic in what they have contributed to what our movement is about. And really, they should all be celebrated. I'd like to give all of them a round of applause. But there has to be a winner. So let me tell you who the winner is. Yeah, they are sticky.
They are sticky. They're gummy.
Yeah. This year's winner for the Special Achievement Award of the Handheld Learning Awards 2009 is Dawn Halibone.
I'm not going to do a Kate Winslet, it's fine. I am very rarely speechless, and now I am. I have to thank the children at the school I work at for their enthusiasm every day for what they want to learn, for my teachers, head teacher and staff at the table over there, who, without their support, the job we couldn't do. For Graham for putting conferences like this together to give teachers like myself to come and see the work that's been doing. For Scotland, who are at the table there, for their innovative work that inspires teachers like me every day. And all I want to say is thank you, and we're deeply honoured as a school, and just keep doing the innovative stuff, guys, because it works. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. Brilliant. Well, I've had an amazing day learning about the incredible technology being used to transform learning, and I'm being genuine. I really have. It's really inspired me. And what's interesting this year, as a new author going into schools, it's been an education for me, because I kind of understand now. I mean, I get through my children, through meetings at their school, I get the sort of message about how hard it is for learners, educators, teachers to wade through all the stuff you have to deal with and actually get to the job of inspiring people in all kinds of different settings. And I can see as I go into schools this year how difficult that can be, and how you think the system is kind of against you, and so it makes your achievements today and the work that all of you in this room do that great deal more impressive. As you know, I said earlier, I get to see a great deal of innovation as I travel the globe in search of cutting-edge gadgets, but I've got to say I'm just as impressed by what I've seen today. Congratulations to all of the finalists and, of course, the winners of the Handheld Learning Awards 2009. Have a great evening. Now it's back to Blues of Kane. I'm reliably informed, and if my ears didn't deserve me when I was listening to them earlier, they are the best jazz and blues band in London. Enjoy them. Enjoy the rest of the evening. Good night.